Hey guys, it's Corrales, and welcome everybody to Quali Beach. You might be like, what is this madness? For those who don't know, we're doing a collaboration when it comes to Planet Coaster. Me, Silverhead, and the Delay Designer. And those two are two of the best builders in this game. If you haven't already, subscribe to the channels, all right? And check out every single video they've got, because they are amazeballs. Like, trust me, they're really, really good at the game. And then you have me, which is less talented, but still pretty good at placing bushes and stuff. So hopefully you guys will enjoy this collaboration. This is the third episode. It's my episode. We've seen Silver building the entrance. We've seen Lady Designer building a restaurant. And now it's my turn. So let me just go through and show you the park how it is for the moment. But everybody, subscribe to Lady Designer and the Silverhead. Links in the description. The Silverhead. This is going to be links in the description, so just check them out and subscribe. And this series is going to be running every single Saturday on one of each channel. So next week it's Silverhead, and then the Designer, and then I think it's New Year's Eve or something, or day, it's me again. So anyhow, Quali Beach, this is the thing Silverhead created in the first episode in this collaboration, and holy crap! You know everybody, I'm a sucker for bushes, and Silver is a master when it comes to decoration details. Just look at this entrance. Like, do you guys remember my park? That sucked monkey balls. And then you have this beautiful structure. The whole park is going to be going in a Polynesian, that kind of theme. So you get all those like cool little rooftops and whatnot. And I think we can work with it. This is just amazing. I've never used this. This is kind of like a little like, ew, Hall of Fame type of thing, I guess. So that is the building. We'll check it out more later on, I guess. But then we got Lady Designer, which did this in the second episode, which is the Tiki Chiki. It's a restaurant. Got Fox Coffee over there. We have something on the side here, which is Mexcelente. So there's got to be Mexican. Then we have beautiful toilets and everything is just custom. It's just amazing. It's just beautiful. It's just bushified and stuff. And then it came to me, which is this episode. And I've been thinking like what to do. And I do have a rough idea. First thing when I heard this is going to be like a Polynesian type of thing. When did they add birds? What is this madness? Where have I been all my life? Where have they been all my life? Like, I mean, come on, I have not seen them. Look at them, they're beautiful. So, the first thing which came into my mind when I heard, dang, they're the shadows, was Polynesian. And I thought, like, those Bora Bora beach huts, you know how they look cool they look. And the problem is, I'm gonna, like, if I do the beach huts, right, I'm gonna destroy the whole area here. Because now we got an entrance building, we have a beautiful restaurant, and then come Corrales. There's a big lake with beach huts in. And it's going to be like, no, this guy can hats on the water, right? So I thought, I'm still going to do it. This is a very ambitious project, so I don't think I'm going to complete it today. But it's going to be a little podcast or Q&A with me, Lady Designer, and Silverhead. So you're going to listen to that. And while you listen to that, it's going to be a speed build of me doing it. And I'm thinking, like, I'm going to place it here, just behind the restaurant. Then what I kind of thought, we could have a beach head around here with some like beach bars and stuff. I guess maybe a little hotel on the side. And then the beach huts just looping around in the water. It's going to be amazing, I think. I don't know. But this is incredible. Like, this is the first time I see it. I've seen it on video. But, you know, when you see it on video, it might not be the same thing as you see in real life. Like, the level of detail up close and personal is just incredible. Have I said that before? Yes, I have. Like, everything is so custom. Amazing pillars, this amazing tower. Silverhead is known for making custom tower stuff. Yeah, that looks pretty nice. That looks really nice. And this is a nice feature as well. All those rocks and pebbles and bushes inside of them. All right, so everybody, enjoy the Q&A podcast type of thing. And I'm going to get crafting. First, I'm going to make a beach hut, I guess. And then we're going to use that. This is the stone as well. Ooh. So enjoy and make sure you subscribe to everybody involved in this and smash the like button as much as you can with your hamster, grandma, use your grandpa, I don't know, just use something to smash the like button, okay? Everybody, enjoy. So welcome everybody to our Q&A. Hi Sil, hi Lady Designer.
Hey.
Hey man.
Hi. Oh, how are you guys doing today?
Oh, I'm fine, how are you?
I'm great. So meanwhile, people are watching stuff in the background here. We're just going to be doing a little Q&A just to have a little relaxing feel of the whole thing, right?
Exactly, yeah, because in the last couple of episodes, there were actually a couple of things that we kind of wanted to talk about, but completely forgot to mention. And in the last episode, we just said, you know, if you have any questions, you can just leave them and we'll talk about them in the next episode. And that's where we are right now. So there were lots of questions in the last video that just sort of clear up this series in general, but also like how we're approaching the game. And that's what we want to get back to in this video.
I think it's good that I'm here today because I listened to the previous episode and that sounded very romantic in my opinion. Because I missed out on the recording session and
Let's not talk about that. You little lovebirds
were like all in there and stuff. What the crap?
No, nothing was going on. Nothing of the sort.
Uh-huh. No. I feel like the third wheel here. Or the fifth. What do you say?
The third, right?
The fifth. Oh, yeah. Oh my God.
It's really not that bad.
No, we were just having fun. We can get along. Well, right?
Yeah, for sure. Well, sometimes.
I heard. Totally heard. So it's going to be a Q&A, a little bit of maybe even like a podcast type of situation, right?
Mm-hmm. It's so many things at the same time. Yes. It's really vague. This project in general, it's just, you know, let's hook up and play this video game together and see wherever it's going to land us.
Because, I mean, today's the third episode, right? So it's a very brand new series so far.
On your channel, it is.
This is brand new. People haven't seen that. Hopefully, they've seen the other episodes, right? And guys, if you haven't, go check them. There's going to be links in the description to everything. Please do check them. But we do have some questions. Should we just get on?
Yeah.
I guess.
Who's going to read the questions?
We just do them on like the order that we've sort of put them together. We couldn't get back to every single question just because there are so many of them. But we took out a couple of questions that we thought are quite interesting to talk about, you know, related to the game or related to what we're doing here. So I think the first interesting question here is one that is posed by Arizo Light, who asks, what is one feature that you wish would be added to Planet Coaster?
Well, for myself, I would say like I haven't played the game for 2 weeks or something. Maybe that's been added, but you know how the water in City Skylines, how you can tweak it and it goes about like dynamic. What you gonna call it? Dynamic water? Liquid. Maybe not dynamic.
Water. I think you can call it dynamic water.
It's just kind of like which is updated through terraforming and stuff. I wish they could add that in Planet Coaster so you can make like those amazing waterfall features and whatnot in it. Because it's a little bit. Lovely. The water looks amazing in the game, but there's something that is just missing, and that's that like the water feature and how water just moves about on the map. I miss that.
I totally agree, though. I think kind of the reason why they're not doing it is because it would be extremely heavy on the game, and there is already a lot of crowd simulation going on and a lot of very detailed scenery in the game already. That I'm not really sure how well it would handle it. But something that I would love to see, kind of in that sense, is maybe like larger, more scenery pieces of waterfalls, not necessarily dynamic water itself, which would require a lot of processing power on your computer's half, but more like animated texture scenery pieces that have all of these particle effects instead of actual animated water, which could replace like all of the waterfalls and rapids and anything moving that you would want to make, while making it a bit easier maybe, and making it easier on the game as well. Just something that I would love to see, and I think could also work quite well. But even though I would love to see some dynamic water, I don't think it's something that they're going to add into the game anytime soon.
I guess not, no.
I hope they do.
It's just very hard to do it. We'll see in the future, though, because there were so many things so far that I was just kind of like, they're never going to do it because it's too hard on the computer, just like the RGB color selector. They were saying for a huge amount of time, you know, we're not going to add that because, you know, it's going to take a lot more processing power to take all of these different colors instead of just the 32 colors that we provided. But in the end, they somehow just put it into the game like, oh, yeah, by the way, guys, you can now select all of your colors yourself. So I don't know, maybe some stuff will still happen.
Yeah,
the game is pretty hard. Like it's really like a demanding game, especially like with the amount of details you guys already added to the park. It's already struggling, and we don't really have any rides yet.
No,
that's
that
a very
true.
Good point. That might be partly my fault. I couldn't hold myself in.
It's your fault.
May I suggest something too to be featured in Planet Coaster?
Oh yeah, sure.
I would love to see fireworks. That would be so awesome with the triggers and that kind of stuff, and then make your real firework show. That would be lovely.
That might be added now. There's an update the 15th, right? the Christmas update.
There's going to be a winter update.
And... yeah, but we have New Year.
Yeah, that's a very good point, actually. I didn't hear anything about this yet. That's a really good point. Because they didn't really say anything about what the winter update is actually going to have. They are just sort of throwing it out there to make a little bit of a hype. But that aside, I have no idea. And I think it's something that would actually be pretty feasible. You know, like you said, we have the triggers already, and there are already so many like of these special effects elements in the game. And, you know, of course, fireworks were one of the biggest features of Roller Coaster Tycoon 3, which Frontier made as well. And it's up to this point, it was really the big roller coaster game still. So it's something that we could very well see in this game. I would love to see it.
Yeah, my gosh.
That's a good thing.
We have Arcadiz is something asking, what theme slash coasters would you guys like to see in the game in the future? And what is your favorite roller coaster in real life?
So
this
first,
one's pretty
awkward
hard.
Silence.
Silence.
Well, you're gonna think about it, right?
Theme,
because it's,
yeah,
it's two
themes.
Questions at once. He's trying to be sneaky here.
Well, I'm not going for the coaster question, I guess. I will stick with the theme.
Yeah, I'm on a theme. Just thinking.
Yeah, but I would love to see some more jungle-ish stuff, like more ropes and more plants and that kind of stuff, and more wooden, I don't know how you call it, wooden prop, foliage you call it, I don't know. And what I would also love to see is some more, how you call it, I lost it, spooky stuff.
Blanks? Posts?
Spooky stuff.
Spooky stuff.
Oh yeah.
We only have the wooden trees and the witch and some other abandoned trees, but we don't really have, if I'm right, we don't really have a lot of spooky stuff.
Yeah, because there's not a spooky theme. I actually remember there was a lot of discussion back in like the Alpha 1 days, because people would go into the files of the game, and at this point there was nothing said about a spooky theme, but people would go into the files of the game and like dig up everything, and somewhere they would find like the scenery files. And along with the themes that we already had, it had a spooky map in there. So everybody was like, oh, wow, we're going to get a spooky theme. And eventually just turned out that I think what happened is the spooky theme just kind of disappeared because it got turned into like a part of the fairy tale theme. So all of the pieces that were spooky were like put into fairy tale. And it's just sort of become a larger theme because of that. But there's not like a specific Halloween slash spooky theme.
Exactly, and I would love to see that in the game as well. So I will go for a jungle and spooky,
I don't know what. Like, I mean, the thing about the plant coaster as it is at this stage, you can pretty much create everything you want to create, but you have to use, like, there's no shortcuts to it. You have to just think the long way around and really modify everything and just create what you want to create. But I can't really think about a theme. Like I love Western. I love the piratey thing. Fairy tale is a little bit limited, I kind of feel like, still in the game. Like, yeah, because of the spooky stuff, like, I try to do like a spooky area, and you tend to do the same things over and over again because of the limit of the trees and stuff. So,
yeah, that's true. It's kind of hard. That's why I'm hoping for some new features for that theme. Would be lovely.
How's I'm not.
Oh, sorry.
Really? Yeah, I'm not really a big fan of the spooky theme, so it doesn't really count for me. But what I did find interesting is that you can just about do anything if you're going to put a lot of time into it, which honestly, most people are not going to do that. You're not going to spend an hour making a pumpkin or making a skull if you would rather just want to have one in game. But I did see a lot of like different like pumpkins actually on the Steam Workshop as well, and a lot of these spookier elements which you don't have in the game itself but on the workshop instead. And what's funny is that for me on City Skylines, I would always have these like workshop hunts where I start looking for these assets and scenery on the workshop to get and put in my parks, and that's something that I haven't actually done yet in Planet Coaster. But like in
that's
the sense of scenery, especially
this is another game.
Yeah, exactly. But in the sense of scenery, especially as like more people start uploading stuff to the workshop, and they might start, you know, developing all of these different themes from the workshop itself, making different themes might even become more easy using the workshop at some point in the future. Just something that, you know, might happen.
Yeah.
I hope that happens somehow.
Yeah, you're right about that, I guess.
I've got a couple of like very small tips that I kind of want to throw out there that are like not really anything substantial, but like some very small tips that I wish I knew when I started playing the game right away, which is just more or less the shortcut. So you have F, which centers an object on your walls, so you never have to worry about like your windows not snapping onto your walls in a symmetrical sense, or your doors not snapping onto the walls, right? Like whenever I'm placing windows or doors, I just press F and it gets snapped to the middle of that wall. Mm-hmm. Also, Control X is super useful. It duplicates an item while staying on the 3D gizmo. So when you're placing fences or doing anything that you want to have on the same level or on a similar rotation, you just press Control X to duplicate it. And mm-hmm. you can start moving it from the original axis where it was at, which can save you tons of time. And, well, just in general, using the 3D gizmo by pressing X instead of, like, separately rotating and placing everything can save you a lot of time as well.
And when it comes to building, I think my advice would be just to check out other players. Check out videos, check out workshop items, see how people use certain items for a different way, and it is inspiring me very much. I really love watching at other people's stuff, and it really helps to get you along in the game, I guess, to see what kind of possibilities you have, because there are tons of possibilities and tons of themes you can sometimes think of yourself.
Inspiration.
Yep, yeah, just exactly. General inspiration. Can we start on the next question?
Yes,
we all. Oh, sorry, if you were just going to slow for your liking. Okay, let's go. Let's
jump. No. I thought we pretty much burned out that one. Like, that was,
yeah, we did. We're just spinning in circles around.
Did we address the question yet of how we stumbled upon Planet Coaster, which is asked by Vincent Van Gogh here?
Vincent, how did I stumble upon? Well, I've always been a fan of coaster games, obviously, so you kind of kept track of it, and then Roller Coaster World got released and then got kind of crappy reviews and stuff. So attention turned to Planet Coaster straight away.
So what was the first thing that like made Planet Coaster known to you? How did you find out about the name?
Silverette? Who is Silverette? I don't know.
Who is really? Silverette? Oh, yes. That's pretty cool.
Oh, Silverette, that guy.
As a matter of fact, you guys, I don't know if I ever told you guys, but you two were the only two YouTubers I was following before I started YouTube myself.
Oh.
So you guys inspired me to do YouTube.
Holy crap.
And, and I think Corellis was the one that made me play City Skylines, but I didn't do it on my YouTube channel. And that's where I found Silverette, I guess. And Silverette was playing Planet Coaster, and I was like, I need to get that game now. So that's why I bought Planet Coaster.
Sweet. So yeah. You pretty much landed the perfect video series to be a part of.
Exactly.
Straight away.
I am the most luckiest girl in the world.
I guess that sort of made me think, because for me, it's a completely different kind of course. Like, back when Planet Coaster was announced, I was a hardcore Roller Coaster Tycoon 3 player still for 12 years. Like, this little, like, town of a couple thousand Roller Coaster Tycoon 3 players. Well, maybe just a couple hundred. We were, like, a very small, tight-knit community that would still play this old game that the rest of the world doesn't give a crap about anymore. But, you know, Planet Coaster was announced, and we were all like, no, it's happening. Like, finally, the rest of the world has realized that this genre doesn't need to be, like, needs to be acknowledged, actually. So that's kind of how I got to know about it. It was just a huge hype. But what was kind of funny was that I didn't get Planet Coaster before I got Roller Coaster Tycoon World. I first got Roller Coaster Tycoon World to try that. And then I was like, nope. So I refunded that. And, like, within 1 hour with my refund money, I bought Planet Coaster. And I do not regret that.
Never look back.
Nope. Well, I do look back sometimes, like at this moment. It's pretty funny. But that aside, no, it's been a great decision, and it's been a lot of fun so far. And
it brought us a lot.
Yeah, definitely. And especially since I'm coming from the RCT 3 background, and like, I'm a hardcore Roller Coaster Tycoon fan. For me, this is really my Roller Coaster Tycoon 4, even if it, you know, technically isn't. It sort of spiritually is for me, in a sense.
Yeah, I can imagine that. I love Roller Coaster Tycoon 3.
Oh yeah, but that's a completely different topic, though. You don't want to get me started.
No,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no,
How long are we recording right now? Is anyone paying attention?
I think around 20 minutes, 22 20 maybe minutes, something. Yeah.
Okay,
there.
So we started at about 29.
Move on, I guess. By the way, did you guys ever play Theme Park and stuff, those games back in the day?
I played Theme Park. Well, no, wait. Theme Park, I'm not sure. Is Theme Park the one with the dinos? No, it isn't. That's before that time. The Theme Park is a bit too far before my time. But yeah, Theme Park World is a game that I played a lot.
Yeah, the old Theme Park. Yeah. Oh my god, I played that on my Amiga. 2 bits. The good old days.
Oh wait,
days.
No, this game is either called Theme Park World or Sim Theme Park, but that's a game that I used to play a lot before Roller Coaster Tycoon.
It was amazing. Back in the day, when I was young. Growing up. Hi, yeah. Okay, next question. Move on. I wasn't getting all sentimental here.
What's a really good question that we should ask at this point? Do you have any ideas, lady?
Have you guys met in real life?
No, we have not. I have not met you guys. We were like Gamescom. We were pretty close to each other, I guess.
Yes,
but we never got the chance
to
meet
each
other.
That's a pretty good story, actually. And I don't think anybody here is allowed to tell that story except for lady.
Am I? Seriously?
Because you were the one who suffered that night.
Okay.
That sounds wrong already. My wife.
That sounds extremely wrong. Okay, no. I take that back.
Okay. So we were at we were invited to Gamescom, Sylve and I. And DocM77 is a friend of yours, right, Corellis?
Yeah.
Yeah. So he was
right, Corellis. He's your friend, right?
Excellent. Yes, my friend.
I'm talking to Corellis right now. But I knew about this, and I was talking at Gamescom that I loved your channel and I love you as a person. Well, how I know you as a person from your YouTube channel, of course. And he was like, maybe we could meet up. And so that was the first day we arrived, and I was so freaking tired, and I think it was like 8 p.m. or something like that. And I was like, there was like an Elite Dangerous meeting that evening, so Silverette was going to there with the other guys. And I think it was 8 o'clock, a quarter past eight, and then I was sleeping. And then the next day, I saw 10 minutes later, Doc texted me, "Yeah, I'm going to the hotel with Corella. Do you want to meet up?" But I missed it because I was sleeping. And I felt so bad that day because you were leaving the other day. So I haven't got a chance to meet you. But now we're doing a series, so that's okay.
I had a beer at the hotel in the lobby.
Yeah, and I was sleeping.
In the lobby bar. You were sleeping, so we didn't meet each other. But I went to the Elite Dangerous meeting, but I didn't see Sylve there, though. No.
You went there? We were in the same room? I just now heard this. What?
Wow. Yeah, me and Doc came by. We had some food upstairs, and then we went down into the dungeon, the castle dungeon.
Oh my.
And chilled for a bit. We had a few beers.
That means we must have been in the same room for quite a while there, and I haven't seen you a single time.
Oh, wow. Yeah. I was
this
in disguise.
This story is getting even worse now.
No, but when we came by, I think there was like Ed was having like this talky thing, and everybody was like,
I remember that talk. Yeah.
Super hyped, and we just chilled on the balcony up there. I guess me and Doc had a few beers, and then we left.
Did you have that buffet at all?
Yeah, we had a buffet, but it was afterwards.
It was so
like
good.
Me and Doc was the only people eating at the time when we arrived, because we came by at like 10 or something in the evening.
Mm-hmm. Wow. So we both missed our chance to meet Corellis in real life.
But
so
there's more Gamescoms. There's more. We will meet each other, I guess, one day. There's so many conventions around.
I guess we will. Yeah, probably. But still.
But I'm an old man, you know. I can't really take the travel anymore. My heart can't take it anymore.
Shut up, you're not.
Can't drink any more alcohol. It is what it is. And so, we haven't. But you have met each other, right?
Yeah, we've met each other
a couple of times.
Three times?
I don't even remember anymore.
Since you're in love. So.
No, we went to Gamescom together and we went to the launch party.
Mm-hmm.
And those are the two.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think that's the only two times.
And we talk a lot on Discord with some other guys as well.
Mm-hmm.
So, that aside, we have never met in real life and there is nothing between us.
There's nothing between
us. So the love story ends here, right?
Lies and deception.
Lies and deception.
No, I'm just kidding.
Okay, so let's go back to the plant coaster related question.
Yeah.
How did you guys get this idea, building a park with other people, says Jeever King?
Yeah, that's a great question, because I don't even know who came up with the idea in the first place.
It was not me.
That's Corrales.
Oh, it was me. Hey.
Yeah.
It was me. My idea.
Yeah. We were talking about on Twitter.
Yeah, collaboration of some type. Yeah.
Yeah, at Gamescom. Because we didn't met, and then we were talking on Twitter.
Yeah, then we could do something together. Yeah.
Yes.
Like a little park together or something of that type. Yeah. But it was me. It was my great idea.
It was you. Oh, yeah. I'm a great thinker. I'm so happy.
I'm amazing at this.
You did very well. Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah, and so far I haven't done an episode. Well, I'm doing it now, right?
Yeah, you
but,
I think you are.
Yeah, I'm doing it right now. Yeah, I'm doing it right. Well, not really. Well,
we are so
people
curious.
Watching the video, right? But you have no idea what I'm doing.
It is so lovely. Yeah, no, we're just going to come and pretend. It is so lovely looking. Look what you did with the water. Are you going to build a water?
No.
Oh.
making a jungle.
Making
a jungle. No, I'm just kidding. I think there's water involved on the screen at this stage. Some about at the entrance. There's a little water. There's a puddle. It's a little puddle. Puddle of water.
Puddle. I love the way you said that. Like your accent in general. Okay, I'm not gonna fangirl. I'm gonna keep that fangirl inside. But like your accent in general, I just wanted to point out it's beautiful. Like puddle.
Absolutely.
And like the bendy roads for the bendy people, and it's just,
yes. Wow. Guys, you're making me blushy. Thank you.
I'm sorry for
I really love the accent.
It's a strange accent. Like for those who doesn't know,
cool.
I think most people know, but I'm Polish, but I live in Sweden. I live here since I was 5. But I speak Polish a lot with my family and stuff. And then I speak Swedish and English, obviously. So every single language kind of mixed together. And it just becomes this crazy accent. And also, I live in a part of Sweden which has got the most amazing accent, like the south part of Sweden. And they talk so differently from the rest of the people in Sweden. Uh-huh. So there's another combination of accents. It's like just a mess of accents. It's bad.
I really love
overall,
it.
It's bad.
Don't ever change it.
No, it's bad.
No, it's not. We love it.
Thank you.
But I'm not the biggest fan of Scottish accents.
Scottish?
Yeah, because it's the kind of thing that everybody always loves, and it's almost like the mainstream.
You might take our lives, but you never take our freedom. William Wallace Braveheart, how can you hit on that guy? Now I'm disappointed, Sil. Okay, this is the last episode in the series.
Wow.
Scottish accents are
amazing. I listen to 500
miles
every day.
Put I
that
love
aside.
Scottish. I
Which
love
one is that?
Irish. I love
one
everything.
Won't walk far. Is that
exactly fire? That song? Right. That's just fire Scotland in a song.
I
do kind of like the accent. I suppose it's just their overusedness that sort of got me to not like the accent anymore.
Yeah, I guess. Like, I guess. I just find Scottish people, Scottish accent, to be amazing. Because Scottish people as well, I guess, right? But accents are pretty cool.
All right, should that wrap it just about up for this
that's,
video?
That's going to wrap it up. Well, maybe not a video, because you know me, I'm going to continue after this. But just this Q&A thing is like semi-podcast type of situation, because we had like a little accent thing going on as well. So that took 10 minutes to explain the accent questions.
I don't think
and
it
stuff,
was just the accent thing. We went off topic many times in there.
That is bound to happen. That is bound to happen.
All right, so that just about wraps it up for the Q&A section. Thank you guys so much for listening. And Corrales is going to end up this video without us for a little bit, just to finish up this video neatly.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, thank you guys so much for watching.
And don't forget
thank
to
you, Corrales,
ask questions.
As well,
for having us on your channel. I had such a blast.
Yeah, this is kind of like the virginity lost on my channel, right? For you both.
More or less. This is my first time on your channel. So really, thank you. For allowing me
no, no problems. Thank you for having me in the series, Abby. Come on, you know you've seen my stuff.
Thank you for thanking me for having you.
No, but thanks again for asking us to do this collaboration, because I am having so much fun.
Okay,
really
we can all kiss
this.
Now. That's been great.
Well, leave me out of it, all right? Because I know I listened to the previous episode, and you were pretty having a little thing going on the side. So leave me just alone, okay? I'm gonna. Bye. I can hear you.
All right. No.
Bye.
So basically,
thank you.
Basically, it's been great, and this has been it for our little podcasting. It went on for much longer than we actually expected. There goes our entire planning and schedules. But hopefully it's still been fun and at least in some ways, perhaps even insightful for those of you who were interested in some of the questions that we wanted to talk about.
That was professional. That was YouTube professionalist.
Thank you.
That was really good. I'm amazed. Perfect.
Cool. Great. Thanks.
Don't be so serious. Thanks.
He always wants to be serious. I don't know why, but
no, I'm just bad at not being serious.
Welcome back, everybody. Hopefully you guys enjoyed that. Like, we promised ourselves to record for 30 minutes. We carried on for like 55. And my time-lapse footage was only like 25 minutes, and I included quite a bit of boring parts as well, just to kind of stretch it so we could have more questions. It was just impossible, but I had to cut out so much. But hopefully you guys enjoyed, so check them out. Amazing people. And in front of us, the ambiance is very high. It's a sunset over the Bora Bora huts type of thing, and it's far from perfect. Like, when I was done with this, I was just watching their stuff over here, and then I was just comparing my stuff to theirs, and I was like, well, that's a sad feeling. But it still took like 25 minutes in 12 times speed up. That's about 6 hours, and I cut out tons of parts as well, so it took about 6-7 hours to complete it all. But it's far from done. This project is just not meant to be for an episode, but I like it a lot. First of all, let me just go up here. I'm going to go to like 12, just go to noon. There we go. So now we can see at least what's going on here. There's a lot of huts. So first is first, aerial view. I was thinking about the Bora Bora huts and how they got the paths and then the huts in the water, very shallow water. And that is what I wanted to recreate. If I did manage to succeed it, I just don't know. Hopefully I did. Like, I mean, they look pretty nice. We get some privacy here to the sun deck. As you can see on the cottage, we have some sun beds. don't judge them, right? There are some planks, but they do look kind of pretty. We got a lamp in the corner and little balconies. What I wanted to do here from the front is just to have so much privacy. So we only have like windows. Well, we do have those windows though, but we do have a little windows higher up here, maybe like a living room. And then we have a bush in front of the window here just to block off people. People can still walk about here and just like go to the front door and check it out and stuff. But privacy. And one thing which I'm not happy about, but it's like for me, it was literally impossible, was the roofing. Like, there's no thatch roof which are like curved in a curvature, so you need to make your own. And depends on the lighting. Like, when you check them out from this side, like, look how nice that looks. But when it gets like the certain time of day, it just looks really crap. Is that bird? What's that bird doing? It's a submersive pigeon. It's a sub pigeon. Whoa. That was cool. So yeah, it was really impossible with the roofing and how that looks. But I still think it's good. Like, it might need some tweaks, but I'm not really going to tweak it. But what I'm going to do is do the paths, obviously, place those planks all over the place. And what I really focused on, because I've been staying in a place, not Bora Bora, because that's far away and very expensive, I guess. But we went to Malaysia once and we stayed at a hotel, which was very similar. And they had like this most amazing night features with like light spots into the water type of thing. And it was so awesome at night times because you can see all the fishes, you can see the fishes and the squiddies and everything. So I tried to focus a lot of lighting here. Like, if we just go up here and there, it looks like this shot from far away. It looks amazing. Close up, yeah. But far away, this looks really nice. So hopefully you guys are a little bit proud, I guess. Like, I mean, comparing to that, maybe not. But still, like, for being me, this is quite the thing. I like it. I like it a lot. So hopefully you guys enjoy this. There's going to be a lot of, like, I think next episode, I'm going to continue on this a little bit. Because it's far from done and I really want to complete. If nobody else is going to tackle this project, because we're going to help each other out. Like, somebody's going to do that, somebody's going to help out and stuff. So maybe Silver or Lady Designer will kind of jump in here and do the things. Like, you just see this railing is to be extended. But on the other hand, oh, by the way, look at this little like, yeah, what you going to call them? The hanging mat bed type of thing. What you call them? Holy crap, my English, GG's English, is gone now. It's pretty late at night as well. I've been recording, like, I've been playing this game for like 7-8 hours now straight, so I'm pretty tired. If my voice is tired, I'm pretty tired. But it looks really atmospherical, and that's what matters. So now we just need to figure out how to make the beachhead here connected nicely, maybe with some restaurants and whatnot, and just make it like to a big, nice looking park. Like, look at all the yellow lights here. Ba-bam! Just white. But I like it. I like it. I think I'm gonna keep it. If they're not gonna change it, I'm gonna keep it white. Holy crap, there's a bird infestation around this place. But anyhow's, everybody. Once again, hopefully you guys enjoy. Smack the like button. Check out Silver and Lady Designer. Amazing, amazing people when it comes to this game. Amazing people to everything, I guess, right? Because you can't just say this game. I mean, they're amazing at everything. Also, I think in the next episode, I'm going to add some coral reefs, like different flowers and bushes inside of the lagoons here. Also, what would be really cool to have is maybe a water ride inside of this. Like a log, maybe not log flume, but the rapid around this place, because that's going to look really nice and cozy. But everybody, once again, check out Silverette and Lady Designer. Hit the like button, subscribe to our channels, and the next episode is going to be next week on Saturday on Silverette's channel. So don't miss out, because this is going to be epic. Well, I hope it's going to be epic. But with that being said, I'm off to bed. Super, super tired. See you guys in the next episode in 3 weeks. Or maybe even a little like Q&A podcast type of thing on Silver's episode next week. Everybody, much love and bye-bye. Damn, this looks nice. Let me just... What I love about doing islands like this, if you rise it up in elevations from the area, it looks like a little atoll. Like you have like more shallow waters around the island and it just goes to deeper water. That is a great tip if you want to get into like those tips and stuff. Haven't really seen it up close. Well, I have, but I haven't really spent time because I've just been doing placing bushes and houses and tweaking stuff. But until next time, see you guys and bye-bye. Have a very, very, very nice day.